Good day, and welcome back to TMac FPV. If you're fairly new to FPV or coming from using a transmitter with a different system firmware, you may be unfamiliar with OpenTX, and right now, might be a little uncomfortable using it. I completely understand that feeling. Today, I'm going to clear things up by going over only the OpenTX basics you'll need to know for setting up your FPV drone or quadcopter. This will include the general concept of information flow within OpenTX. By understanding this general concept, it'll make it much easier for you to set up your model and your transmitter to perform exactly how you want. I'll also use a couple specific examples to demonstrate this concept of information flow using my Jumper T16. However, the stuff we're going over today applies to any transmitter running the OpenTX firmware. If you're ready to clarify your understanding of OpenTX and make it easier for you to set up your quad, make sure to give this video a thumbs up below, share it with your friends, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel. Your home for your journey to better FPV. Fun, lights, and racing. Stop.
So you've got yourself a Jumper T16 transmitter with OpenTX system firmware on it. If you have one without OpenTX, or you'd like to update your OpenTX version, I encourage you to check out this video at the card in the upper right, or at the link in the video description below for how to do that. But what exactly is OpenTX? Well, it's a highly flexible, feature-packed, open-source firmware for RC models of many types, not just FPV drones or quadcopters. And because it's designed with that flexibility and all those features for many types of RC models, it has 11 different model menus, which you can see here. It's sort of like candy. Candy's good, and so is the flexibility and all those features within OpenTX, but if you try to eat a bunch of candy all at once, you might get sick. In our case, for FPV quads, we may get information overload. We don't really need to use all those features for our FPV quad. In fact, we really only need to use 5 of them, those being model setup, inputs, mixes, outputs, and telemetry, if we're even using a full telemetry receiver such as the Jumper R1, FR Sky, RXSR, or a similar telemetry receiver. I've got product links in the description below for both the R1 and the RXSR. If you've never heard of the Jumper R1, go ahead and take a look at this video through the card above or at a link below. I'll go over each of these 5 menus today, and I'll start with model setup and telemetry because those are very simple and we can get those out of the way quickly. Then we'll get into inputs, mixes, and outputs, which form the basis of OpenTX information flow. And I'll explain the concept behind how these work together. So when you're armed with this information flow concept, you'll be able to implement some really cool things with your quad in the not-too-distant future, all on your own. As you can see, we've already streamlined the use of OpenTX for our model setup from 11 menu items down to 5. Now we're just going to eat some of this candy a couple pieces at a time. We can always go back for more. First, we'll look at the model setup menu. Here, there's really only 4 things we need to do, if that. Input a model name, use a model image, not necessary, but it's an available feature and sort of cool, and if you want some help on how to do that, check out my video on Jumper T16 custom images. Then you can either scroll up to get to the last page or scroll way down to the section on either internal RF or external RF. For our demonstration purposes, I'll use internal RF. Here's where we set our failsafe mode to no pulses, select our mode for our receiver, and if you're using either the Jumper R1 or the FreeSky RXSR, you want to select FreeSky D16. You'll also want to select your channel range, normally 1 through 16, and set your receiver number for your quad. Here I'm using 2 since it's the second receiver I'm binding. Then you just click on bind and the transmitter will begin beeping. This is when you hold down the bind button on your receiver while at the same time plugging the battery into your quad. It takes a little bit of talent, but you'll get the hang of it. I've got other micro FPV quadcopter build videos which show this binding process if you're interested. Or, better yet, check out our Fast Track FPV course at tmacfpv.com, which goes over, among many other things, the entire processes for setting up both your transmitter with OpenTX and your quadcopter with Betaflight in a simple step-by-step logical approach. That's it, we're done with our first menu in OpenTX. That wasn't so bad. Next, we'll go to our telemetry menu. After we've bound our receiver to our quadcopter, there's really only 2 steps we need to take here. Scroll down to discover new sensors and press enter. Once the sensor data has been populated, if you're using a full telemetry receiver, just click on Stop Discovery. 2 OpenTX menus down, and only 3 to go. The last 3 menus form the basis of our OpenTX information flow. They are inputs, mixes, and outputs. Within OpenTX, the information flows from various sources, which can be your transmitter sticks that you use to control your quadcopter, switches, either the many physical switches, sliders, and knobs your transmitter has, or logical switches, or any of the telemetry values which you just saw populated from your receiver. Within the inputs menu, you can modify the values of these sources. The first 4 inputs lines are used as your stick controls. Usually, the only other input line normally created for FPV quads is using a telemetry value as your source, that being RSSI. We'll take a look at two examples of inputs here shortly, one for modifying the value of your throttle stick using a curve, and the other using that RSSI telemetry value I just talked about. The information contained in these inputs lines can then be passed to your mixes menu, which is used to map your sources to receiver channels for output. The sources for your mixes menu can be inputs lines from your inputs menu, or they can also be switches and these various other things. Normally, I use the mixes menu to assign transmitter switches to receiver channels to activate different things in Betaflight. We'll take a look at two examples within our mixes menu, one for assigning a switch and the other for using the input line established for RSSI. Once your sources have been mapped to receiver channels in your mixes menu, that information is then passed to the outputs in your outputs menu. In your outputs menu is where you'll set your channel center, minimums, and maximums in conjunction with Betaflight for your sticks travel. In general, here is where your outputs channels receive the information passed on from your mixes and converts that information to electrical pulses, which are then transmitted to your quadcopter's receiver. So basically, that's the concept of how information flows within OpenTX and how these three menus work together. Now that you have this overview, let's take a look at a couple quick examples for each of these menus. In our first example for our inputs menu, we'll be using our throttle as our source for our input, and we'll modify it with a curve. I won't be getting into how to set up the curve. For that, you can check out this video.
It's a very simple process. You just go to the input line you want to create or modify, press and hold enter, press edit. Our source is throttle. Here you can see we've got a one-to-one linear relationship between our stick movement and our quadcopter's response to the throttle. I'm going to modify that by using a custom curve. I've already created that curve, as I mentioned earlier, and the reason I did that was to get better throttle resolution at a certain altitude range, which helps me to maintain my altitude in that range. It's not necessary to use the throttle curve, and I'd say most people don't. I'm just showing you this for demonstration purposes on how you can modify a source, in this case your throttle stick, with the inputs menu. So I'll insert the custom curve now. And you see our quadcopter's response to our throttle stick as our source in the inputs menu is no longer linear. That's how you can modify the value of source within your inputs menu, which can then be mapped to a receiver channel using the next mixes menu as we described earlier.
For our next inputs example, I'll use a telemetry value as our source, specifically the RSSI value. Since we've already discovered sensors earlier, we have RSSI as an available source.
To create an input line, we just go to an empty line and press enter. Insert an input name. I'm going to call this RSI. Then for our input source, we find RSSI from within our telemetry values. They're on telemetry now. And we want RSSI. We don't want plus or minus, we just want RSSI. There it is. You do have minus and plus. We want just regular RSSI. Now you see here, we have 0 dB, our scale set to 0 dB. We want to change our scale to 100 dB. So the range for our RSSI is 0 to 100. Then we just hit return to exit out. And here you see we've got our RSI named input line using RSSI as our telemetry source, which can now be passed on to our mixes menu.
Now we go to our mixes menu, and for our first example here, we'll use the RSI input line we just created as our mixes source and assign it to a receiver channel. We do that in the same way we just created the line within our inputs menu, except here we're actually placing it on a receiver channel, not just an empty line. In this case, I'll be using channel 12, which is what I always use out of force of habit. We push the enter button and use the scroll wheel in the same manner we did earlier to navigate our screen. So I just go to channel 12, press enter, click on edit, and input this information over here for our RSSI mix. Since all of our mix ranges are from minus 100% to 100%, we need to change our weight, or rate as some people refer to it, to 200%, and our offset to minus 100%. That will take our 0 to 100 dB range we had on our inputs menu and convert it to our mix range scale. Then we just press return to exit out, and we've got our RSSI telemetry value assigned to our receiver channel 12, which can now be passed on to our outputs. For our next and last example on our mixes menu, we'll assign a channel to a switch for use as our arming switch. You can assign a lot of switches to a bunch of channels to perform various functions, as you've seen I've done here. The process is the same for each, you're just using a different channel. So I'm only going to demonstrate this for one switch. This isn't everything you need to do for switch activation, as there's still stuff to do in Betaflight, but that's beyond the scope of this video.
To show you how simple the process is to assign one of these channels to a switch, I'm going to go to channel 5 and create my arming switch. So I'm going to scroll down, press enter, name it. I'm going to name it arm for arming. Then for our source, click enter. And when it's flashing, you can pick whichever switch you want to accomplish whatever function that you're trying to program. In this case, I'm creating an arming switch. So I always use the same switch for arming, which is this green one down here. So in order to get that switch here, all I need to do is flip it. Switch F, press return, exit out, and now on channel 5, I've got switch F, which is my arming switch for my quadcopter. That's it.
Now we're at the end of our OpenTX information flow with the outputs menu. Remember I said earlier, here is where the information from our mixer gets transformed into electrical pulses, which are then transmitted to your quadcopter's receiver. What we want to make sure to do here is set up our center point, minimum, and maximum endpoints correctly. We can do that by going to the receiver tab in Betaflight with props off our quadcopter, having it plugged into our computer with both the LiPo connected and our transmitter on. Then we just observe the center, minimum, and maximum values at center, min, and max stick deflection for each axis. The center should be 1500, the minimum should be 1000, and the maximum should be 2000. If any of those values are not the correct value, we just click on the appropriate entry for that channel and use the scroll wheel to adjust the value in our transmitter until we obtain the correct value in Betaflight. Most of the time, the value is going to be between 97.5 and 97.9, positive and negative. To adjust the minimum, we hold the stick to its minimum deflection and use the scroll wheel to change the value. Here you can see in Betaflight, the value is going down to 994. We want it set at 1000, so we use our scroll wheel to get it to 1000, and at that point, we click the enter key, and now we've got it set to 1000. We do the same for a maximum value. We deflect our stick to its maximum deflection and change this number until we get to the maximum stick deflection of 2000. Now I'm using the terminology 1000, 1500, and 2000, whereas on this transmitter screen you're seeing values in the 90s and 100s. These values are in percent of stick travel, whereas in Betaflight, these values correspond to microseconds of the pulse. Once all that information gets transferred into electrical pulses of the proper durations, it's then transmitted to your quadcopter's receiver, which takes it from there. Pretty amazing stuff.
So that's the basics of OpenTX for FPV quads using our Jumper T16 transmitter. Remember, these things apply to any transmitter using OpenTX firmware. Although OpenTX is feature-packed, I've shown you don't need to start with everything all at once. You can start with these 5 menus and progress with more advanced features later. I've also demonstrated for you the concept of information flow in OpenTX between inputs, mixes, and outputs. With this understanding, I hope I've eliminated some of the mysteries surrounding OpenTX and increased your confidence in using it on your own to configure some fun stuff with your quad for some outstanding FPV adventures. If you found this video useful, give it a thumbs up below, make sure to share it with your friends and spread the word, and subscribe to your TMac FPV channel. Let me know your thoughts on OpenTX in the comments below. Thanks for your time. I'll see you next video. Clear skies, friend.